one particular marble stone that's pretty famous for Milford, and it kind of puts us on the map, is the stone of Carrie Cutter. Carrie Cutter, if you read the stone, is the wife of Calvin Cutter. He's a doctor, grew up in Jaffrey, prominent family, all bunch of doctors in the family. She was a Hall, Carrie Hall. She lived down in District Number 5, down south of Osgood Pond area, as we think of it nowadays. But Carrie was she had a lot of brothers, and they were all working in the mills. They all worked in, the oldest one was Martin Hall. He worked as a blacksmith and a carriage maker right here in the middle of town. And all the boys worked there, and it was kind of a dirty job, but she kind of wanted to marry above. So she marries this doctor, Dr. Calvin, that's making his way in Nashua, prominence. But she kept her Milford roots. Living in Nashua, the two of them were quite involved in the Baptist Church. If you read Carrie Cutter's gravestone, right after Caroline H. Cutter, wife of Calvin Cutter, it says, murdered by the Baptist ministry of the Baptist Church. Then it goes on with another 150 words on the face of this marble stone, all the way down to the dirt. Much of it you can't read these days. Calvin and his buddies had this idea that we're going to make a ton of money. We're going to build a Baptist church on the north side of the river to service those women that are working in the mills. And if you know anything about Baptists, they believe in tithing. So every dollar they make, they give 10 cents to the church. That's tithing. So they, and it's part of being part of their ministry. So they got the builders, they put it up, they raised the money to build the church. Much of it came from Caroline's family here in Milford. There's quite a few prominent people in town that donated to that cause because they were supporting the Christianity, right? They're supporting the Baptist Church. Things went bad. Things went sour. The original guys that started in on it, they were part of the Baptist Church on the southern side of the river. They kind of backed out and ended up, the builders didn't get paid. Calvin was disgraced because he had all his loans pulled back from these folks in Milford. But he wanted to be heard, and that was his big thing. He wanted to be able to tell his story and to say, you know, his side of it. He had ordered a gravestone for his wife. She's still quite alive, Caroline. But they had this gravestone made, and it named all the names of all the people that he accused of slandering him in public and slandering her because she spoke in his behalf as well. So he said that the church actually caused her death because they brought them into a poor state of poverty and of disgrace. And he had that all typed out, all hand-carved by a guy in Amherst onto the stone. It wasn't ready, so people are hanging around the cemetery, Elm Street Cemetery. If you've ever been there, it's not a big cemetery. 1,000 people would hardly fit in there. But as the sun's going down, they bring the stone out and they start placing it in place. It was raised by a light of a lantern. I don't believe a lot of people could read what it said, but it was just full of slander. It was a lot of what was said there was right out of the tract that Dr. Calvin was spreading around, and it was all there on the stone. So it wasn't until the next morning when a lot of people realized all the slander, and Caroline Cutter herself was probably standing there in the crowd. But there was another Caroline. There's another Caroline Cutter. I suppose she was born in town as well. And she ends up becoming the first woman to serve the country, serve in the United States in the military. If you were to go there today, you really can't read the writing on the stone because it's worn away by the acid rain, but it's blocked by this memorial to Carrie Cutter, the first woman to serve her country.